In this video, we're going to solve another problem using node voltage method. This circuit has several different sources, a voltage source, a current source, and a dependent current source. And also in this problem, ground wasn't defined for us. So since we have a choice, I'm going to make this bottom node ground. And the reason I'm going to choose this bottom node as ground is because, as we learned last video, if one side of a source is ground, then the other side is known. So, okay, this node here is our reference node. Okay, so this is ground here, where voltage is zero. Okay, and then this node here, there's 23 volts at this node with respect to ground, so that's known. So the only unknown nodes is this one over here that I'll label A, and then this one right here between the 6 ohm and the dependent source that I'll label B. So this is where we're going to have to write our node voltage equation. So we'll set up a KCL at node A and node B. So here at node A, I'm going to define a current like this that I'll call I1. And I picked I1 going down to agree with this polarity that was given for Vx, which is the voltage across the 2 ohm. And then I'm going to have a current like this that I'll call I2. And then a current here through the 6 ohm that I'll label I3. Okay, so now KCL at A will just be that, let's see, we've got 1 amp flowing in. And we've got I1 plus I2 flowing out. Okay, then KCL at node B will just be, okay, so KCL at node B is just going to be I3 equal to 2Vx. Okay, so then we have up here, we're going to write the currents in terms of voltage using Ohm's law. So I1 will be VA minus 0 over 2, and I2 will be VA, let's see, VA minus 23 over 12. Okay, then down here I3 will be 23 minus VB over 6, and that's equal to 2Vx. Okay, and if you look at where Vx is in the circuit, over on the left side of the circuit, the voltage across the 2 ohm, well, that's equal to VA. So we can write Vx as VA. Okay, since Vx is equal to VA. Okay, that's why I can do this. So now up here, if you solve for VA, you'll get that VA is equal to 5 volts. So that's one of our answers. And then you plug in 5 volts here, solve for VB, and you'll get that VB is minus 37 volts. Okay, so those are our answers for our node voltages. Now, as some practice, you know, with taking these answers and then finding out, you know, circuit quantities using, you know, the fundamentals we learned prior in the course, make sure that you can find on your own here, make sure you can find the power for each of the sources. So the power for the 5 amp source, you should get 5, or excuse me, the 1 amp source. Okay, power for the 1 amp source, you should get an answer of 5 watts, and it's supplying. And the power for the dependent source, you should get an answer of, Let's see what I get. I got 370 watts. Okay, and that's also supplying. And then the power for the voltage source, okay, the 23 volt voltage source, you should get an answer of 264 and a half watts. And again, that's supplying. So all the sources in this circuit are supplying. Okay, so there's one more major topic involving node voltage method that we'll discuss in the next video.